You had them without that first 45 minutes.
Well, as I said, first 10 minutes, I thought we started quite bright and looked lively and got the goal, and then I thought, well, that's looking good, and then again, just individual errors, and every time we made an individual error, we lost a goal. So I said it before the game, the problem being is if you keep making individual errors, keep being punished, you're never going to give yourself a chance. So it's as poor as I've seen, and the worst I've seen in terms of mistakes, and as I say, every time we did, they scored. And then obviously we needed a reaction, and the second half we were a bit better, but by the time that was damage was done. So as I said, a lot of hard work ahead of us, because we have to improve, we have to stop losing goals that we're doing. I mean, 10 goals in 2 games is just not like us. The success we had in terms of from Christmas to the turnaround we had was clean sheets and defending properly, and that's what we need to get back to doing. So because we can't do as we're doing at the moment, as I say, that's not a good recipe for success. So, and as I say, in another day as well, we probably could have scored 2 or 3 more, you know, could end up 5 each. But as I say, that I still wouldn't have been enjoying that, because to lose 5 goals at home to anybody is not good enough. So, but as I say, the first half has killed us. As I say, after the start we had as well, bright start, and I never foreseen that coming, because it's just something you can't as a manager put down. I mean, individual mistakes, people getting the ball away and not reacting, and miskick clearances, you could go on, you know, and as I say, it's disappointing. But we need to dust ourselves down, and we've got a game on Tuesday night, we need to obviously be better and start, as I say, working on a lot of stuff, that back to basics, and just learn to defend properly and clear your lines properly and do the right things, and as soon as we do that, then things will change.
I mean, I think it compounds it with the fact that the quality of strikers that I'll always got.
Oh, I mean, Alan comes in here, I mean, they're playing with great confidence, you know, and I think, obviously, it doesn't help it, you know, because, as I say, we're giving them gifts, you know, and it's just sloppy play and carelessness, and, I mean, you had the first 2 goals, it was a throw in the corner, and then the second one was our goalie's in his hand, you know what I mean? So, I mean, what can you do as a manager? It's like, that's what I say to them, I mean, these mistakes need to be cut out, because you're not going to give yourself any foundation to work on and get success, you know, so... Sooner we realise that and start doing the right things, the basics right, then, as I say, things will improve. We've got to keep believing in ourselves. You know, we had a poor start last season. We've had a poor start this season. So, but as I said, as a manager, you don't like to put yourself in this, but you obviously want to go off to a flyer, you know, and don't get me wrong, it's been 2 tough games, Livingston and Alloa, but as I say, we need to defend a little better than that and play a lot better than we did. So, we will do that. It's my job to do that, and as I say, that's what we'll do.
It was a bright spot at the afternoon, Craig Malcolm. He just looked really alive in the box.
Malcolm was our best player, but a long way today, you know, and he probably could have scored another couple, you know, but he worked well, and everything he did was good today. So I said that half time and the 90 minutes. So as I say, you kind of win games with one player performing at that level, you know, everybody needs to get up to speed, and that's something we need to do, you know. So, but we'll work hard, and as I say, we'll keep our heads down, and as I say, the fortunate thing for us, we've got a game on Tuesday that we can hopefully put things right, but as I say, we need a big improvement on that today in terms of defensively and individual mistakes. We need to cut that out to give ourselves a faint chance.
As you say, Tuesday gives you an immediate chance to kind of try and get back on track.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, as I say, we need to make sure we do the right things and get back to basics and keep clean sheets and defend as a team. And that, I'm not just talking about the back four, from the front right through the midfield and the back four, we need to be better and harder to beat and be more compact. And as I say, the individual mistakes, it's just killing us at the moment, because we seem to just keep making mistakes after mistakes, and every time we do, we get punished. So that's something that's got to stop. And as I say, we'll make sure it does, because if the players keep making the same individual mistake, that player will need to come out of the team, and we'll get somebody that doesn't make the mistakes, you know. So, but as I say, I've still got faith in these players. I know there's some good boys in there. When you look at the team on paper, we're far better than that. It's just we're not doing the right things at the moment. So as I say, it's up to me as a manager to turn that around, and I'll make sure I do.
You mentioned Alloa coming here full of confidence, 6 wins on the spin. How do you make sure that the Stranraer team, the confidence remains there when, like say, you come in 5-1 down at half time?
Well, it's difficult, because I mean, I never saw that coming. I mean, that's, as a manager, you'd only be 5-1 down, and at the end of the game, I mean, 45 minutes, so as I say, everything that seemed to go wrong went wrong after that. After, as I say, the bright start we had, I mean, the first 10, 15 minutes of MD had come in, and we'd never foreseen that, you know. So, but as I say, every time we make an individual mistake, we seem to get punished, and I don't know if it's a nervousness or that, but we're just slicing, missed kick clearances and not doing the right things. And as I say, I'd rather been over the tree at the side of the park than where it went, you know. And, you know, so as I say, a manager, you can't fathom that, you know. Obviously, it's players you know are better than that are just doing that, you know. So, but as I say, you just got to keep believing in them and giving them the confidence to make sure we can turn this round. And as I say, a lot of hard work is required, and we'll do that to make sure it does.
What do you say at half time in a game like this? Is it a case of try and win the second half and salvage a wee bit?
Well, the biggest thing obviously is not to lose more goals, you know. Five is bad enough as it is, you know, in our mind anymore. So, fair play, we obviously kept a clean sheet second half, and we won the second half 1-0. But, as I say, there's no gratification on that. So, as I say, the damage was done, and as I say, big improvements required for the games ahead, whether it's Spartans and Tuesday and the Airdrie Saturday. We need to get back on track. I mean, for me, we need to start winning league games as well, because that's the main aim for us. It's the main ambition we've got as a team. And as I say, I know there's a few teething problems at the moment, and we're trying to get the right balance and everything else, but hopefully, as I say, with hard work and believing in ourselves, we can do that.
So as you say, obviously, you don't, as impressive as the turnaround was last year, you don't want to be in that position in the
match. No, I don't want to start playing at Christmas, you know, it seems to be. So as I say, we need to get that into our system, you know, and start doing the right things and keep believing and keep working hard and have a wee bit more confidence in ourselves to do the right things. And as I say, when it's on, you put your laces through, just put your laces through. And as I say, no team's going to score from just in their own half, you know, well in their own half. So that's something we need to get back to. As I said to them before, you see top teams, even Premiership teams in England, when their defenders clear their lines, they clear their lines, you know. So that's something, as I say, we have to get back to doing, back to the basics, and let these teams make mistakes rather than us. So as I say, hard work ahead, and we'll make sure we do that. Yeah,
thoughts on that one, Jack? Another brilliant result for you.
Yeah, I mean, I think the nature of the game meant that the players were probably a little bit flat when they came in, but I think if you had given us a scoreline prior to the game, we would have been delighted. So, you know, just emphasise that to them, that it's about looking at that bigger picture, and they were really, really good for that large spell in the first half, and, yeah, you know, we took chances when they came our way and scored some really good goals. So, very pleasing, because I said prior to the game that it's arguably the most difficult place in the league to come, so to come here and win in such emphatic fashion is very, yeah, positive for us.
It must be even more pleasing, the gritty fashion in the second half. They really dug in and got, you know, did the ugly side of the game well.
Yeah, I mean, we are going to have to do that at times, and we're going to take plaudits because we have good players in forward areas. I thought more than that the pleasing thing was that we came back from going behind, because, yeah, we haven't had to do that this season, either in the League Cup or in the league. So, you know, conceding so early away from home was a really good test for us, and the response was, I think, better than I could have hoped for. You know, I think we also created several other chances in the first, yeah, half, particularly, you know, Greg had a few more, but, you know, you've got to be really happy. And, yeah, there's a bit disappointed that we gave him so much encouragement at the early part of the second half by conceding, but thereafter, you know, it was a little bit scrappy and we were under pressure at times, but, you know, we were fairly resilient as well.
Seems to be a lot of goals and within your group, right? You must be delighted with the firepower you've got now. It's 11 between Jordan and Greg, I think.
Yeah, I mean, I think I've repeated myself often enough in that we have players that will create and score in forward areas, and it's happening for a lot of them at the moment. I think they're all in a good place psychologically, they're in a positive frame of mind, and we've scored a lot of good goals in that period. We haven't scored many scrappy ones. Yeah. You know, hopefully we'll add that as well, but certainly I don't see why these players can't reproduce that form over the course of the season, because they are good players and they are a threat going forward. And, we'll always feel confident getting into games that we will create and score, yeah, so long as that continues.
I was just saying to Greg there that the Celtic draw has probably come at a brilliant time, just to even more competition for places and boys on their toes, and just keep the momentum going with that.
Yeah, I mean, I must admit the draw was slightly disappointing to begin with, because I think we would have wanted a draw, you know, at home, yeah, I think, first of all, and then when you look at some of the, you know, it's the hardest possible draw we could have. However, yeah, when you go into the club and you sense excitement around some of the other people at the club, then you, yeah, realise that there's a lot to look forward to within it. But it certainly does us no harm in that regard. You know, I think the group anyway don't need, yeah, that type of extra motivation, because they're a really good group. You know, we have our own targets, names within there that we stress every week, and you know, there's a, you have to be relentless to do them. You have to keep going and going and going. It's not easy, it's tiring, but they're doing it at the moment, and we'll keep after them, and they'll keep pushing each other along.
It's Livingston won again today, so it looks like it could be a real, you know, tit for tat between you for this season.
It's still really, really early, you know, still very, very early. And, you know, I think I said last week, you don't win a title in the first couple of weeks, you don't lose it. Yeah. So, you know, they've started in good form. scoring a lot of goals as well. I think there'll be some really competitive matches this season goes along. You know, I keep looking at that fixture list over and over again and waiting to see an easy one pop up, but it doesn't matter how many times you look at it, you know, it's not there. So, you know, we've got another tough match next week. East Fife had a terrific result today and have obviously entered the league in a positive manner from winning the title last year. So, yeah, I mean, still very early to predict who will be challenging come the last stage of the season.
Track, did you envisage beginning of July you go 7 unbeaten?
No, I mean, I thought we could start the season well because we'd ended the season well last year in a really tough league, and with the group we'd put together, I felt as if we would be a good side. But yeah, I mean, to go 7 wins and you know, the fact that it was through a tough League Cup fixture and a quarter, and sorry, in the last 16 fixtures within that as well, is more than you probably could have hoped for. And people always say, you know, the bubble will burst and it's got to come to an end. It doesn't always need to, you know, you have to keep maintaining that belief that you can keep that going, and that's what we're aiming for, and it's great because we've got that now. You know, we've got this run going, and there is a real desire to keep it going for as long as possible.
I mean, does this disprove the theory that it takes a while for players to gel?
Well, I mean, you know, you need, I'm not going to pretend to be a genius, you need some good fortune, you need things to fall in your way, and they have came together quickly as a group. We kept ones from last year who were really good types, good players, good characters, and I think I've said this previously as well, I've worked and played with and known a lot of the players that I've brought to the club, so I trust them. And I think they trust me, and it's a good starting point to have. You know, that relationship is there, and as I said, they have hit the ground running in that sense, and it bodes well for the rest of the season.